Whisky, love it or hate it, has a rich and complex chemistry. And this chemistry gives whisky some fascinating properties that could help a multi-billion dollar industry you wouldn't think has anything to do with booze. Our whisky adventure begins with a photographer named Ernie Button, who noticed that when a drop of whisky dries, it leaves residue pretty much everywhere the droplet was. Compare that with the world-famous coffee ring where the residue forms, well, a ring. Usually on your table. Coasters, people. Ernie wanted to know why whisky dries so differently, so he started reaching out to scientists to find out. He got in touch with Howard Stone, a chemical engineer at Princeton. Although Howard doesn't drink much whisky, he's very interested in fluid dynamics. He also knows uniform drying is a big deal for the paint and coatings industry, which is worth billions of dollars in the US alone. So a better understanding of how drying works would be a good thing. And Howard's office is right across the street from a liquor store, and if that's not a sign from the universe, I don't know what is. Now, whiskey and coffee are obviously different. For starters, whiskey has alcohol in it. But mixtures of water and ethanol, the alcohol in alcoholic beverages, don't dry uniformly like whiskey does. Howard's team created several different mixtures to mimic whiskey and found two key ingredients that are very important to whiskey's special drying properties, surfactants and polymers. Whiskey gets these naturally from plants used to make it, corn, wheat, barley, etc. Whiskey's surfactants are phospholipids, and its polymers include lignin and polysaccharides. So the Princeton team created a whiskey mimic by mixing ethanol and water together with a synthetic surfactant, sodium dodecyl sulfate, and a polymer, polyethylene oxide. The team also added some fluorescent beads so they could actually image the drying process without affecting it. The Princeton mixture was pretty spot on in terms of drying like whiskey does. In whiskey and in the Princeton mimic, ethanol evaporates faster than water, changing its concentration and setting up a concentration gradient. This gradient creates a type of fluid motion known as Marangoni flow that essentially stirs a drying droplet, which is good for uniformity. In coffee, there's no ethanol gradient to set up this stirring. Once all the ethanol evaporates, the whiskey surfactants drive a new flow to pull particles away from the droplet edge. Again, you don't get this in coffee, so the stuff can and does settle at the edge. The last critical whiskey ingredient, the polymer, helps anchor other particles in the solution to the surface, keeping things in place instead of getting pulled around by the droplet. Coffee doesn't have this anchoring system, so its contents go to where the fluid flows. Guess where that is? A ring around the edge of the droplet. Stone says these whiskey experiments are simpler than what companies do to develop commercial coatings. But his team's simplified model revealed the important roles of a few key ingredients in uniform coatings. And it made us wonder if adding whiskey to your cup of joe could keep it from forming coffee rings. Leave your guess in the comments, then check out this video to find out if you were right. Thanks to Ernie Button, Howard Stone, and postdoctoral researcher Hyoungsoo Kim of Princeton for talking to us about their work. And for giving us an excuse to do whiskey experiments.